mankind is consuming more and more electricity, and at the same time, CO2 emissions are increasing dramatically. Our planet is heating up. If we keep going at this rate, we will be heading directly towards a climate disaster. But this is not necessarily unavoidable, according to a certain Swedish scientist. Worldwide, the carbon dioxide emission due to the electrical generation is around 40%. It would be technically possible to use renewables to cover Europe's whole electricity demand by 2030. It's a bold statement, but Gunnar Asplund knows exactly what he's talking about. For over 40 years, he's been intensely occupied with high-voltage direct current, known by experts as HVDC. The advantage of this direct current technology, it's possible to safely transmit large amounts of electricity over long distances without losses. However, in the transmission of alternating current that is widespread across the world, large quantities of electricity are lost over long distances. All electric power in Europe could be produced in an area of around 20,000 square kilometers in the Sahara with solar power. Or you could produce it from sea-based wind power in the North Sea. The problem so far has been that the transmission of such a huge amount of power has not been possible. A look at history. The so-called war of currents at the beginning of the 20th century was about the technology of the future. Alternating current prevailed. At the time, AC was easier to produce and more profitable than its competitor, direct current. There was no demand yet for large amounts of electricity, and the length of the transmission line did not yet play an important role at this time. In the 50s, direct current again gained significance with the development of HVDC Classic, the predecessor of today's high-voltage direct current technology. But it was still at the very beginning. HVDC Classic, as we call the first generation of HVDC, has some limitations. The first is that you can only transmit power between two points, the second is that you cannot go underground with cables, and the third is that you cannot build HVDC grids. This is exactly what the Swedish scientist wanted to target. In countless experiments and test runs, Asplund perfected the pioneering high-voltage DC technology and solved one problem after the other. He even found the right answer to the question of power grid stability. If you build an HVDC grid, you need to introduce some kind of fuses in order to make it safe like you have at home. In an HVDC grid, however, these fuses are much, much bigger, and they're called HVDC breakers. They certainly are bigger, and this is what they do. Huge amounts of electricity are transmitted over long distances through cables, even underwater, to the mainland. That is why HVDC breakers are installed, so that local power grids do not collapse due to overload. They can interrupt a current flow of up to 1 gigawatt in a mere 5 milliseconds. That's about as long as a fly bats its wings. The last problem was solved. In 1997, Asplund's invention, the new HVDC light, was presented to the world. A sensation. Thanks to the Swedish scientist, there's no longer anything standing in the way of an energy revolution. If you want to transmit a lot of power and use traditional AC, you need many transmission lines. But if you go to HVDC, you can reduce the number of lines considerably. Should you go even further and use HVDC light, you can take away the transmission line and go underground, which saves nature. Whether in America, Brazil or Norway, many new HVDC light connections were developed in the following years. Finally, the world can be supplied with electricity from renewable energy sources. And countries with a lot of sun, water and wind can profit from the new power exports. For his achievements in the development of new high-voltage direct current technologies, Gunnar Asplund is now nominated for the European Inventor Award 2015.
Ja, att bli nominerad till det här priset.
This is of course a big honor and a big inspiration. But it's not only myself who has done this. Of course, it's a lot of people who have been working together with me to achieve this technology improvement. Gunnar Asplund and his team of Swedish scientists have made it technically possible that Europe could very soon be supplied with energy free from fossil fuels and nuclear power.